to you are the political issues that the country is facing in the present times?
I think the most important issue that comes to my mind is that all the political parties, irrespective of ideology, I think they must remember that India is a multicultural society, and we need to preserve the multiculturalism, the fabric of our society, and therefore we have to preserve the idea, principle of secularism. So that is the most important issue that comes to my mind, besides other factors like, you know, unemployment. I teach in a university and I deal with the young people, and they're not bothered whether you build a Ram temple or you build a mosque. You know, they are more concerned about education, getting good education, about getting jobs. So I think that is more important than good employment. So that is important, you know, for health facilities, educational facilities, good infrastructure. So they are not concerned with, you know, ethno-religious issues. They are more interested in developmental issues, growth, equity. So other issues like farmers' distress, which has been one of the reasons, you know, important reasons that led to the defeat of the BJP in the recent elections.
Okay, ma'am, you've just mentioned that, you know, the BJP earlier when it came to power in 2014, mm-hmm. and Mr. Narendra Modi took over as our Prime Minister in May 2014, it was the political atmosphere in the country was such that this particular party along with its allies would go on ruling for a long time. But now it's just they haven't even finished their first term, and it has the feelings and the political situation has actually changed, and people are again turning towards the Congress there. The party that was being termed ineffective and the one that would be thrown out from the country. How do you look at the situation concerning all those views from the BJP?
I think when BJP came to power in 2014 elections, it got a majority, you know, after almost 30 years, it got, you know, majority. But now you're right that even after 5 years, you know, it has faced this defeat in the Hindi heartland. So it is a alarming bell for the BJP, because BJP came to won the 2014 elections on developmental agenda, but I think from there it started moving towards, you know, ethno-religious issues. So I think they should realize they will be facing the same dilemma that they faced in 2004 elections. You know, whether to stick to Ram Mandir or ethno-religious issues, or more crucial issues of Roti Kapla Makan.
That's right. Yeah. That's right. So, ma'am, we have been facing the last question with you, for you. The country has been facing distress in the farming. The farming community of the country is also facing distress, major distress. So, what do you think? Where do you think the country or the successive governments have failed to do the required, have failed to make the required efforts for the farming community?
I think most of the parties, I won't target or name any one party, but I would say that they have really failed to address to the issues of the farmers. And even if you remember in 1999 when BJP, you know, in 2004 when BJP lost election, that was on the issue of India shining. And there was a lot of, you know, anguish among the people. Where is India shining? Most 80% of the people live in villages, and farmers were committing suicide as they are doing now. So I think the politicians, they need to realize that it's not about just urbanization, building, you know, infrastructure. The real India lives in villages. So they have to, you know, look into the interest of the farmers and, you know, take action steps, adequate steps, you know, to address to their concerns.
Professor Rekha Saxena, thank you very much for speaking to ETV Bharat. Thank you.